Hi you guys, it's me, Michaela, and I'm back with another video, and this one is for back pain. A lot of us deal with this back pain, but before we can really get into trying to reduce the back pain with yoga or stretching, you have to remember that our back plays a major part in our day. Everything we do on a day-to-day basis affects our back. Like, for example, posture, the most important thing. You have to remember that your back is not supposed to be super hunched. You're not supposed to be slouched like that. This is no support for your back. Your core can't do anything right here. Also, this ain't cute either. And it's gonna hurt after a while, because then your back is thinking, oh, I need to sit like this all the time. No, that is not how we're sitting. Your back needs to be strong, straight, reaching for the sky, but also grounded. You need to keep it like aligned at all times. Well, when you can, you know? Because then these back muscles, they're like, okay, we're up, we're gonna get strong, and the core is like, I'm gonna support you while you do it. So remember, keep that back straight as you can at all times. If you're just sitting around, just remember, oh, is my posture correct right now? And also, like, being on our cell phones and our laptops, we're never really giving our neck support, and that, come on now, that's part of it. You can't have try not to look down all the time, you know, try to like lift your head up, because I know my head is heavy, so there's people out there who have heavy heads and their neck is just tired, but if you need to, lay down. When you're working out, make sure that, you know, you're stretching before and after. Make sure that your back support is good. You're using that core. And driving. I know a lot of us can't get away from driving, you know, around and driving to work, whatever, but try not to drive as much. Or if you're trying to just look cool while driving, like however cool people drive, you know, don't do that. It's gonna really hurt you. So just look at the things you do every day on your back. Like, that is really the most important part of reducing that back pain. Alright, so to start, we're just going to pull out a few things. A blanket. So, if you need it. So, we're going to start crisscross as always. And if you need to, like, lift your butt up off the ground a little bit, you can do that with a blanket or a towel, whatever. I have black tea because, as you can tell, these allergies are like not working with me. So, yeah, excuse me for that. We're gonna start crisscross. First thing we're gonna do, keep that back straight. Spine strong, tall, not overarched, not hunched. Pull those shoulders back, chest open, and just breathe. Breathe in a new day, new air, new life. Deep inhales through your nose. Hold it for a few seconds and exhale through your mouth. First, we're gonna do a slight turn to the left. And how we're gonna do this, just place your left hand on the mat beside you, right hand on that left thigh. Keep that spine straight and strong. Let your head go wherever your chest goes. Yeah, follow your chest. So we're turning to the left and we're deep inhaling. Hold it here for a few seconds, and when you exhale, you're gonna be back in the front. Deep inhale to the right. Spine straight, chin is following chest. Hold it for a few seconds. Exhale, and back towards the front. Now, we're just going to reach that right hand behind us. Grab the right elbow with the left hand. Spine still straight. Chest should be open, shoulders should be back. Switch. gonna bring those hands above our head. Spine still straight, tall. Let your palms touch right above your head. If they're not able to touch right here, bend them a little bit so that they can touch. Or if not, hold those hands with some space in between them straight above your head. And we're just gonna breathe here. And next, we're gonna just allow our body to fall forward. But when we're doing this, try to like really use that core in your back strength right here. So keeping that back straight, hands right beside your head. And if you need to, use the wall, use a dresser, whatever. So I'm here, I'm falling. If my core gets a little, you know, weak right here, just use those hands to walk yourself down. And so we're going to do that all the way to the ground. If you're not able to fall to the ground, wherever you stop, that's fine. Just work on your own pace. So we're here. Just breathing and stretching, pulling those shoulders and those hands as far away from your mat, from your body as you can. Keeping that butt on the ground or on your blanket or towel. And just walk those hands back in. Back up. Rotate those shoulders a little bit. To the back and to the front. Now, turn towards your right. Feet out the side. Or in front of you. And now, wiggle those toes a little bit, keeping that back straight, neck straight, tall. And what we're gonna do here, bring your hands out to the side, above you again, and fall forward. Try to reach those toes. If you're not able to reach your toes, reach your ankles, your shins, wherever on you is most comfortable, and just pull yourself down. And breathe. Here. Focus wherever that tension is, that stress in your body. On the exhale, release it and let your body relax. Black hoodie, black tins, black leather jacket, sun beating on my black skin, black wind. When you say the black of the bird, make a spectacular cherry. No, I got more buttons than a black bird. Now we're gonna place this right leg bent over the left leg. So right foot should be like kind of right near your left knee. Place the left hand or the outside of the right leg and twist that body. Try to keep your spine still straight right here. And twist it. Your right hand can be used for support your back from like leaning back. So push yourself up with that right hand and twist. If it's too much for you, just do it lightly. Just sit right here if you need to. And we're going to do that to the opposite side as well. Never let a day go without me blacking out on all these pesos. Crazy because I get so lonely. Can't let just anybody in you own. I need to see. Now, this is like probably one of my favorite poses. It's upward facing plank. We all know what a plank is. It's like push up. Yeah. You're gonna place the hands, palms down on the ground, right up under the shoulders, feet still straight in front of you, and we're going to point those toes towards the ground, use that core, straighten that back, and pull towards the sky. This is about the back core strength right here. Your back is like, it's holding you. So when we're doing this, really pull that pelvic bone, tighten that core, and lift for the sky. Don't overdo it. Like we said earlier, the arch is not cute. You're pulling here. Straighten that body. You feel like a surfboard. Honestly. That neck, don't let it do this. Do that. Use those neck muscles, keep it straight, and just sit here.
If you can't, you see I just had to sit down. So just work yourself into it a couple times. So you can just breathe a little bit while doing that. Until you're comfortable enough to actually just sit in that. We'll take those shoulders again to the back and to the front, and we're going to fall. Focusing on the good in life. Focusing on the good in yourself. Because you've gotten yourself this far, no one else has. Okay, now we're going to lay back. Back should be flat on the ground. You need to use that blanket or anything, like placing it under your tissue or that arch, or wherever you feel like there's too much pressure or your back somewhere isn't touching the ground, place a blanket under it so that it'll feel even. So we're here. We're going to take that right leg, place it towards the sky, straighten that leg. Grab it with your right hand, either on your shin, your ankle, wherever. And take the left hand, place it on the knee or the back of the thigh. Pull it in towards you. If this is not possible, grab like a strap or something and place it on that foot and pull it down towards you. Keeping that back straight and aligned on the ground. Place that right leg back on the ground and do the same with your left. Okay. Now we're going to take both legs into the sky. Take the right leg, bend it, place it over the left thigh or left knee, wherever it's most comfortable. Place your hands through this hole and around the left leg and lock them however, and that right elbow, push out on the right knee and bring in that leg, keeping the back still on the ground. Do it to the opposite side. So left leg and foot on the right thigh or knee. Put that left hand through that hole, right hand behind the thigh, and pull in. Oh, I feel it. Feet towards the sky. Drop those hands behind you, like right above your head. Reach your hands as far away from you as you can and just let your legs fall towards your body. Keeping that spine, back, butt on the ground. Well, tailbone, I guess, because your butt is kind of like, yeah. So we're letting those legs fall towards it as far as we can without lifting. And we're just going to bend those legs now and rest the hands on top of the legs. Don't push, pull it in, just let them rest. Let it rest right here. And now we're gonna just do like a slight rock to the left and to the right. Letting both of your sides really interact. Nice little baby rock right here. Alright, so once we're done rocking, place those feet back on the ground. You can straighten them back out.
And we're going to sit. Now that we're sitting back up, what are we gonna do? Focus on that back again. Posture, back straight, neck straight, spine tall. All right, we're going to bring those feet in. Place those hands between you and just kind of like pull yourself up. So we're here like this like squat. Feet should be under your knees, under the hips, hands should be right in front of you. And from here, we're going to straighten those legs, place the feet on the ground. If you need to, bend the knees a little bit. Bring your body towards your legs. Just stretch right here. And walk those feet back. Now we're gonna go into downward dog. Downward dog is just placing your hands shoulder length apart, feet right hip length apart. If you can, place your heels on the ground, head between your arms, back straight, knees straight, legs straight, whatever. And if that is not possible, we're gonna do dolphin pose, which is just on your forearms doing the same thing. In order to make sure that your hands or your forearms are shoulder width apart, grab them like this in front of you, open your hands, shoulder width apart, and lift up, and we're here. So, we're in that downward dog. And from here, I'm just gonna do a couple calf raises. Slow calf raises. Make sure you're like using all of your fingertips and that palm in your wrist to balance out that the force and weight that you're putting on it right now. Now we're going to go into a plank, keeping that back straight, neck in line with your spine. And from here, we're going to bring that pelvic bone towards the ground, bend the elbows a little bit, knees touching the ground, top of the feet touching the ground, shoulders back, chest out, look right in front of you. You should really feel this like stretching all of your body right now. From here, we're gonna go into child's pose, which is all you're doing is sitting back on your feet, keeping those arms straight in front of you. Rotate those wrists a little bit. Pull those hands back behind you. And make sure you have like just your knees, your legs are right on the outside of your chest so that it's sitting comfortably. Pull those hands right up behind you. Palms up. Forehead can rest gently on the ground. And from here, we're just going to take in everything that we've just done. And think on the good in our life. Think on the good in yourself. Pointing those shoulders towards the sky and rounding them. So it's going to be like this.
right over your knees, and we're going to exhale into cow pose.
Head should be straight. Don't touch your butt. It's all it is. Bring your chest towards the ground, pelvic bone towards the ground as well.
On that inhale, tuck the chin towards the chest. Release it back in front of you. On that exhale.
Fall back into child's pose again.
Going to come back up and sit back in our crisscross begin pose. So that may have helped you in that moment, but the thing with yoga, the thing with anything, it has to be a daily practice. It's not something that's just going to cure you overnight. It takes time. So give yourself, give your body, give life time to get you exactly where you need to be, exactly where you want to be. And just make sure you have an open mind and open heart when doing it so that it really does allow the best energy to flow into your life. Thank you guys for watching. If you have any questions or comments or concerns, anything, ask me. That's what I'm here for. I'll see you guys next week. Full force and she got me like Tadow. I be like Tadow, baby Tadow. Why you so fine Tadow, Tadow. Got the baby.